हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ श्यामल दवांगे। टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द फॉर्मुलेशन एंड इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ हर्बल चूर्ण, दैट इज त्रिफला चूर्ण। सो द रिक्वायरमेंट्स फॉर द प्रैक्टिकल आर मोर्टर एंड पेसिल, एंड द केमिकल रिक्वायर्ड आर अमला पाउडर, हरडे पाउडर एंड बेहड़ा।
The aim for today's practical is to formulate and evaluate herbal mixture. So herbal mixture, we will formulate Trifala Churna. So the formula for this Trifala Churna is, ingredients are Amla, Harda and Behda. Category of this formulation is natural digestive aid, and the direction is for internal use only. And the dose is mentioned that 1 tablespoon should be taken with water.
So the churna, they are solid dosage form and they are based on the number and the nature of the drug and the size of the particles. So mainly based on the number and the nature, they are of three types, that is simple churna, compound churna and churna with metallic powders. And based on the size of particles, stula, sukshma and atyanta sukshma churna are the three types of the churna. So it shall be preserved in airtight containers, and these are the precautions to be taken while formulating the churna. Clean and dried drugs should be used for the preparation. Then they should be finely sifted. Each substance should be powdered separately and then mixed. Mortar and pestle should be clean and dry. Must be stored in a dry container and should not be prepared in rainy season. So these are the precautions to be taken during the preparation or the formulation of churna. So here is a formula. So the ingredients are amla, harde and beheda. So here are the given and the taken quantities. Now we will see about the role of the ingredients. So amla, it is a diuretic. Harde, it is a astringent. And beheda, it is astringent. So the procedure, weigh all the ingredients accurately, mix them properly by trituration in mortar and pestle so that fine powder will be obtained. Pass the mixture of powder through sieve and evaluate the mixture.
So here are the ingredients which are required for herbal mixture, that is known as churna. So we require amla powder, harda powder and behra powder, and we require mortar and pestle. So now we will weigh the ingredients, that is these three ingredients, 6.3 gram, and then we will mix them. Now we will first weigh amla powder. Now we will weigh behra powder. last ingredient. Now we will mix these three ingredients which we have weighed in mortar and pestle. To a fine powder. So here you can see the three ingredients are mixed very properly by trituration. Now we will pass this powder through sieve number 18 to get a fine powder. In uniform size, okay. So this is our churna. Now we will perform the evaluation parameters for churna powder. Before that, I will show you the packaging of churna powder. So now for packaging of churna, you can see we have taken a butter paper and a bond paper. Okay, first we will pack this churna in butter paper Okay, after placing this, we will place this in the middle of the butter paper. Then we will fold this paper into two folds. Then this way. And this part, we will insert this part into the first part. This is how the churna is packed in butter paper. And same way, we will pack this in bond paper. And we have packed the packet of butter paper into a bond paper. So this is how the churna is packed. So now, first evaluation parameter, we will perform angle of repose. Okay, for that we have to take funnel which is attached with a buyer stand, okay, and a graph paper. From graph paper, the height must be 1 cm. I have already adjusted the height. Okay, now we will pass our churna powder through funnel. Now we will draw the circle. And we will measure the height of the peak. So it is 2.8. Now we will calculate the radius. And we'll label these lines as D1, D2 and D3, that is diameter. Now we will calculate the radius of the circle. So now we are, radius is equal to D1 plus D2 plus D3 divided by 3. That is, we will calculate the average of 3 diameters, then we will calculate our radius. So I have measured that D1 is 7.5. plus D2 is 7 plus D3 is 7 divided by 3. So the radius is 7.16. Divided by 2, that is equal to 3.58 centimeter. So now we will calculate the angle of repose, that is theta is equal to tan inverse h upon r. So height is 2.8 centimeter and r is 3.58 centimeter. So theta is equal to tan inverse 2.8 divided by 3.58. That is equal to tan inverse 0.7821. So therefore theta is equal to tan. Now we will perform the tap density and the bulk density. Firstly, we will calculate the bulk density. For that we require the total volume or total mass of the prepared churna powder. Okay, so I have calculated that, and that is 17.25 grams. Now we will fill this powder in this tubes. Okay, then we will note down the bulk volume, okay? Then we will calculate the bulk density and we will keep these for tapping over this apparatus, okay? And then we will note down the tapped value and we will calculate the tap density. So here the bulk volume is 38, okay? Now we will note down this bulk volume, that is 38, okay? We will keep this for determining the tap volume. We will see the volume after tapping, that is 22.5. Now we will note down this volume, 22.5 ml, and we will calculate the bulk density, tap density, Kass index and Hausner's ratio.
So here are the label requirements or the label for Trifala Churna. So the category of the Trifala Churna is natural digestive aid. It should be stored in cool and dry place. Then direction, it is for internal use. And this is the label indicating the ingredients, details about the manufacturing license, batch, date, expiry date. Then its category and the dose is take 1 tablespoon of powder with water or as directed by the physicians. Now we will see about the evaluation parameters. So the organoleptic characters. So the color obtained was buff, odor was characteristic and the taste was sour. Then the powder characters were performed. So the bulk density of the formulated churna was performed. So the bulk density obtained was 0.45 gram by applying the formula mass upon bulk volume. Then the tap density was obtained 0.76 grams by applying the formula mass upon tap volume. osmosis ratio was calculated by dividing tap density with bulk density, and it was obtained 1.68. Kaas index was performed. So the Kaas index was obtained by applying the formula tap density minus bulk density divided by tap density. So the value obtained was 0.45. And the angle of repose was calculated on a graph paper. So the theta obtained was 38.0289 degree. So here is a graph paper for angle of repose we have performed. So we have calculated the radius, average radius was obtained, then the angle of repose was calculated by applying the formula theta is equal to tan inverse h upon r, that is the height of the peak of the formulation and the radius. So the value obtained was 38.0289 degree. So the next evaluation parameter performed was ash value. So the principle involved in ash value is the ash value of organic material is composed of their non-volatile inorganic compounds control incineration of crude drugs result in an ash residue consisting of an inorganic material. So here is a procedure for determination of total ash. So about 2 gram of drug was weighed accurately and incinerated at 450 degrees Celsius until the it was free from carbon. Then it was cool and weighed. If a carbon free ash cannot be obtained in this way, then exhaust the charred mass with hot water, collect the residue on ashless filter paper, incinerate the residue and the filter paper, add the filtrate, evaporate to dryness and ignite at a temperature not exceeding 450, then calculate the percentage of ash with reference to the air-dried drug. So this is how the total ash is calculated. Then determination of acid soluble ash. Do the crucible containing total ash. 25 ml of dilute hydrochloric acid was added. So mainly the total ash is divided into two parts, and to that one part 25 ml of dilute hydrochloric acid was added. Collect the insoluble matter on ashless filter paper, that is Wattman filter paper number 41, and wash with hot water until the filtrate is neutral. Then transfer the filter paper containing the insoluble matter to the original crucible. Dry on a hot plate and ignite to constant weight. Then allow the residue to cool in a suitable desiccator for 30 minutes and weigh without delay. Calculate the content of acid insoluble ash with reference to the air-dried drug. Next parameter is determination of water-soluble ash. So the procedure is same as that of acid insoluble ash. We have to add the total ash, okay, into 25 ml of water and then incinerate it at 450 degrees Celsius. Then
to perform ash value, we will require the crucible. Okay, so now we will note down the weight of the crucible, that is empty crucible. So the weight of the empty crucible is 21.69 grams. To this empty crucible, we will add 2 gram of crude. So now we have weighed already 2 grams of our drug in this crucible. Okay, this is the lid of the crucible. So now we will keep this for incineration in a Muffel furnace. So this instrument is known as Muffel furnace, which is to determine the ash. Okay, so ash value. So here, inside this we will keep the crucible which contain the drug, and here we will set the temperature to 450. Okay, so the temperature is already set, that is 450. Now we will insert our crucible into this chamber. We will close the chamber. And the heating is started. After 6 hours, we will remove the crucible, okay, from the furnace, Muffel furnace. Now we will calculate the weight of this ash. So this is the total ash which is obtained after incineration. Now we will calculate the weight. So the weight obtained is 21.85 gram with total ash. Now we will divide this total ash in two parts and we will perform acid insoluble and water soluble ash value. Now we will weigh for acid insoluble ash. The total ash obtained is 0.16. So for acid insoluble ash, we will weigh 0.08 gram. So this is for acid insoluble ash, and this we will take for water soluble ash. Now we will perform the further procedure. So these are the requirement to calculate the acid insoluble and water soluble ash. Okay, so we have divided our total ash in two parts, that is 0.08 gram for water soluble and 0.08 gram for acid insoluble. So for in case of acid, we are going to use 25 ml of 2 normal HCl and 25 ml of water for water soluble ash. Now we will add acid to this and water to this, that is 25 ml, and we will boil for 5 minutes. Then we will filter this through ashless filter paper and the, we will put this filter paper into the crucible and we will incinerate at 450 degrees Celsius. Now we will boil this for 5 minutes. So after 5 minutes we will filter this solution through ashless filter paper, okay, that is Waterman filter paper. So this is for water soluble. And this is acid insoluble. So after filtration, we will place this filter paper into the crucible which is previously weighed, and then we will incinerate for 6 hours at 450 degrees Celsius in Mofel furnace. So after filtration, we will place this filter paper into the crucible. Which is previously weighed, okay. So this is water soluble. This is acid insoluble. And now we will incinerate this both the crucibles at 450 degrees Celsius in Mofel furnace for 6 hours. Set the temperature to 450 and then place this crucibles into the furnace. So I have placed first crucible of acid insoluble, second of water soluble. And then we will start the Mofel furnace. So after 6 hours, we will note down the weight of the crucibles. So this crucible is of water soluble ash value. So the weight obtained after incineration is 21.71 gram. Okay. And this crucible is of acid insoluble ash, so the weight is 23.64 gram.
So here are the calculations of water soluble extractive value. Same way, the weight of empty evaporating dish was noted as A, then the weight after evaporation was noted as B.
For extractive value, we will weigh 3 gram of powder drug for both water soluble and alcohol soluble extractive value. So I have weighed 3 gram of sample. So here are the requirements which we will require for extractive value, that is ethanol, 2 bottles, okay, empty bottles, for one for alcohol extractive, other for water extractive, measuring cylinder to measure the volume and water. Now we have weighed already the 3 grams of our crude drug. So we will start performing the practical, that we will place this 3 gram of our sample into alcohol extractive bottle. To this we will add 100 ml of ethanol. And we'll shake this. So we have to shake this for 3 to 4 hours or 6 hours continuously with some time interval. Now we will perform the water extractive value. For that we will add this 3 gram of our sample into the bottle. To that we will add 100 ml of water. And we'll shake it. So after shaking for 6 hours, we will pipette out 25 ml from water extractive and 25 ml from alcohol extractive, and we will evaporate both of them, and we'll note down the extractive value for alcohol extractive and water extractive. Now we will note down the weight of the petri dish, okay, that is evaporating dish, to calculate the extractive value. So first, this evaporating dish we will use for water soluble, so the weight of the evaporating dish is 78.50 grams. And This dish we will use for alcohol soluble extractive value, and the weight is 76.15 gram. We will filter this alcohol extractive and water extractive. Then from this filtrate we will pipette out 25 ml of solution of alcohol extractive and of water extractive, and then we will evaporate those on heating mantle, and then we will note down the weight after evaporation, and we will calculate the extractive values which are soluble in alcohol and which are soluble in water, that is percentage of alcohol extractive and percentage of water extractive. Now we will pipette out 25 ml of alcohol extractive. Now we will pipette out 25 ml of water extractive. Now we will evaporate this . So these are the dish after evaporation . Okay so this is alcohol extractive and this is water extractive. Now we will note down the weight of the petri that is evaporating dish, and we will calculate the percent extractive value. So this is the weight of alcohol soluble extractive. So it is 76.54 grams. And this is the weight of water soluble, that is 78.90 grams. Now we will calculate the percent of extractive value.
So now we will see the calculation for the extractive value. So calculation for water soluble extractive value. So weight of empty evaporating dish was noted as A. Then the weight of evaporating dish after evaporation was noted as B. And the value was subtracted, that is A was subtracted from B for the water soluble extractive, and then the value obtained was 0.40 gram, and percent extractive of water soluble extractive obtained was 1.6% by cross multiplication. Next are the calculations for alcohol soluble extractive value. So the weight of empty evaporating dish was noted, then the weight after evaporation was noted, and the value of alcohol soluble extractive obtained was 0.39 gram, and the percent extractive, that is alcohol extractive obtained, was 1.56%. The result was Trifala Churna was prepared and evaluated. So here are the questions to be asked in Viva. So what are Churna? They are solid dosage form based on the number and the nature of the drug. They are classified. So based on number, they are classified as simple Churna, compound Churna, Churna with metallic powders. Based on size of particles, Stula Churna, Sukshma Churna and Atyanta Sukshma Churna. Give the principle involved in ash value. So the ash value of organic material is composed of their non-volatile inorganic compounds. Controlled incineration of crude drugs result in an ash residue consisting of an inorganic material. What are the precautions to be taken during the formulation of Churna? So clean and dry drugs should be used. They should be finely sifted. Each substance should be powdered separately and then mixed. Mortar and pestle used should be clean and dry. Must be stored in a dry container. Should not be prepared in rainy season. Give examples of marketed formulations of Churna. So here are some examples, that is Trifala Churna, Rasayan Churna, Sankul Churna, Sitopaladi Churna. Thank you.